Today, I'm going to show you how I made a 3D virtual choir show. Whether you are here to learn how to do it yourself, or if you are just interested in the technology behind it, this video is for you. First, let's see what we'll be making. This project was a lot of fun to create, particularly because it uses some fun technologies behind the scenes, and for the most part either uses free or open source software. Doing a virtual choir video can be a daunting task to begin with, since you have to deal with lots of source footage that has to be aligned perfectly and then edited together to not be boring. We also have to deal with working in a 3D environment. But just like any other problem we have to solve in our lifetime, it is much easier if we break it down into smaller pieces. I personally divided the project into three discrete sections. The first section is where we do all the individual processing of the files. The second section is where we build the 3D scene. And the third section is lighting, animation, and exporting of the final video. Let's cover how we should film the source footage. When I did this project originally, I did not provide any specific instructions to the students, which was because I didn't know at the time that this would even work. But now that I know it does work, I would have asked for a full body shot of each of them singing along to a backing track. This would help us match up the clips later. If the performers have a green or blue screen, they can use it. But if they don't have them film in front of a blank background such as a wall. Next, we need to remove the backgrounds from each of the videos. If the performer did not film in front of a blue screen or a green screen, we can use an online tool called RunwayML to add a green screen background for us that we can key out later. We simply need to click on the green screen tool under the video tools section and upload our file. Next, we click on the person that we want to isolate. If there are some areas that don't get highlighted in green the first time, you can keep clicking until the entire body is isolated. If there are some areas that are highlighted in green that shouldn't be, you can use the exclude tool to remove it. That's it. We just need to export this video now. This processing will take some time because it uses machine learning and artificial intelligence. But once it's complete, it can be put back into the folder containing the rest of the source footage that has a green screen or blue screen already. Next, we are going to kill three birds with one stone. We need to chroma key out the background, align the video to the music, and export the video into a format that we can handle easily in our 3D application. I used a video editor called DaVinci Resolve, which has a great free version. But feel free to use any video editing software you are comfortable with. First, we will import the music file and drop it into the timeline, and lock it so it does not move. Next, we will import the first source video. We will then line up this video to the music file by trimming either end and dragging the clip around in the timeline. Once everything is lined up, we want to remove the green background. This will be different depending on the application you're using, but for mine, I have to head over to the Fusion tab and add a chroma key node and then adjust the settings till the background is blank. We are finally ready to export this clip. When we start to deal with 3D projects, it is generally a good idea to export in a format that we can scale with the project. The format I'll be using is EXR, which was developed by Industrial Light and Magic in 1999. This is made for complex 3D workloads and will reduce the required RAM and processing power when we go to export our video. Now we just need to repeat this process for each source clip that we have. Since I knew that I was going to have rows of student videos in the final video, I created a timeline with a wide resolution and added multiple videos next to one another. This would help reduce the amount of things that we need to drag around later. With the source footage complete, it is time to move to the fun part, the 3D environment. I am a terrible 3D modeler, and because of this, I just went online and I found a 3D model of a theater that I liked and purchased it and downloaded it. To combine all these elements together, I use an open source software called Blender. This program has a lot of features, and if I were to cover all of them, we'd be here for years. But there are good instruction videos on YouTube that explain the basics. Thankfully, what we are doing only scrapes the surface. We simply need to import the 3D model we downloaded earlier from the File menu. Next, we need to add an image plane into the scene and select the EXR sequence that we exported earlier. Now we have successfully added our performer into the virtual theater. If we hold down the Z on the keyboard, we can see what the rendered version will look like. And as we can see, it does not look very good. This brings us to the third and final section, making it look better. The reason it looks so meh is because we don't have any lighting in the scene. Just like in a real theater, we need lights to add ambiance. In Blender, we have many different types of lights that we can add. Just play around with them till you like the way things look. One neat feature that I was surprised worked was backlighting an EXR image sequence would result in a shadow just like in the real world. I think that the shadow on the ground really helps with the illusion that everyone is there. After lighting the scene, we need to give the video some movement to keep things interesting. We can grab the camera and move it to a starting point, add a keyframe, advance the playhead to the second point, move the camera, and add the second keyframe. Now, when we play it back, we've added some nice camera movement. The very last step is to render out the video. Since we are working in a 3D world with lighting, it takes a long time to render out the video. For reference, this video was around 4 minutes, and it took about 10 hours to render out, so make sure you leave yourself enough time for the rendering process to happen. In Blender, we can select the output format we want, and then select Render Animation from the menu. And with that, we have created our own 3D virtual cloud. As always, if you have questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below, and I will try to get you an answer as soon as possible. And if you found this video useful, feel free to give a thumbs up and consider subscribing to support the channel. And I will see you next time.